In this lesson, I want to animate some vector artwork. So here, I have an encapsulated PostScript file, .eps, that is opened in Adobe Illustrator's vector editing application. As with a photograph, I want to create separate layers. However, this time, I don't have an issue with cloning in a background. If I turn off the visibility of some of these layers, we can see that each layer is complete in and of itself. Another option for exporting is doing so in order to preserve the vector nature of this artwork. Doing so means that we have a lot more flexibility with resolution and motion. However, there's some other disadvantages. So, in order to export these layers, you may think you can just turn off the visibility of layers you don't want and export, but that will not work. In order to export just a specific layer or object, you need to delete all the rest of the objects out of the image. So I'm going to start with the sign. I'm going to select it by clicking this target, which will select everything within this group here. Then from the select menu, I'll choose inverse to select everything else, and then press the delete key, which leaves us with just this sign, just everything in this group here. From here, from the file menu, I'm going to go down to save a copy. This will create a copy of my work with just this element. I'll call it banner. In this case, I'm not able to check the Use Artboards checkbox. We'll see the impact on that in a moment, and I'll press Save. I'll use all the defaults here and press OK, and then Command-Z to undo, and simply repeat that same process. So you can save your separate vector layers as vector objects in the .ai or .pdf formats. So here I have a folder that contains our PDF files, which are our vector images. So I'll select them all and drag them into this new motion project. And first, we can see they're very small by default. Let's also take this sign and put it at the top so we can see it. If we go to the inspector in properties, we can see it's 100% scale. Notice also each of these has its own anchor point that isn't necessarily in the center of composition. In other words, we've lost our overall composition layout of each of these elements. And if we reposition them where they belong, its anchor point will not be centered in the composition. So it will require moving those anchor points. However, one benefit of working with these vector objects is this. I'm going to drag a corner with the Shift and Option keys held down in order to scale proportionally around the anchor point. Notice as it gets very large, it gets very blurry. In the inspector, we can see it's over 2000%. But because it's a vector object, we can go to the Media tab here, select the underlying media, and then in the inspector, it has its own media tab, and we can see a checkbox for fixed resolution, which is checked or enabled by default in order to have the best possible performance. But if we uncheck that checkbox, then this object will do something called continuously rasterize. So it gets redrawn at every scale, so we can make it as big as we want, and it will still remain crisp and clear. I'll back to the Layers menu and select it, and then in the Properties Inspector, I'll scale it up even larger. So now we're over 4,000%, and we can still see it's nice and crisp. So that's the advantage of working with vector objects, in this case saved as .pdf files. If you want to do a move or you zoom very close and move through them, it's a great way to work with them. Click the subscribe button below. If you have an idea, comment, or suggestion, leave those below as well. Go to rippletraining.com for fast professional training on Final Cut Pro, Motion, and DaVinci Resolve from industry professionals.